And that's so characteristic. This is her kind of persistent theme, the crossovers between her identity, as she called it, of Glaswegian, Ghanaian.
Greetings, all you very rare individuals. Welcome to another Afro-Scot podcast. This is episode 17. And we're going to talk about why Africa is great. Specifically, we're going to talk about a fellow Afro-Scot, Maud Sulter. Now, who is Maud Sulter? Well, she's a poet, writer, playwright, photographer, gallery curator. I can go on and on and on. But she's a well-accomplished Afro-Scot woman, born in Glasgow, and one of our main accomplishments is championing for women, African women. And she's very inspiring to me because her accomplishments could match some of the greats like John Cocteau. She was so versatile and extremely skilled and gifted in art that inspired me when I found out about her to keep on going with my art and my work. And I really loved her photography set, where she focused on the myth muses from history, but instead she used black women, African women, in her photography instead of using the myth muses, and she dressed them up like the myth muses, like Terpsichore. I found this very, very cool, because at the time, of course, that reflected on her as well, as in the 80s and 90s, there wasn't that good of a representation of African talent in the United Kingdom, and especially in Scotland. So by using real African women in these photographs is a way of signaling to everybody that we are here, that people should pay attention to us and our talents, especially the African women, as she also was incredibly inspired by African women in the past who seem to have been removed from history. For example, in this photo, she made sure she hid the face of Nadar, one of the founding fathers of photography, but here she made the face of Jean Duval, a muse of Charles Baudelaire, a focal point, showing that women should be appreciated. And in a lot of her artwork, she infused African imagery in European landscapes or European paintings of the past to show that although we aren't really shown in history or talked about in history, we were actually there. It's not just 200 years ago when we were taken as slaves, you know, we were actually there in the past, not even hidden in plain sight, as she makes the imagery the largest subject in the photographs and the artworks. You know, and I believe that Maud Sulter felt more connected to her African side than her Scottish side, as she did a photography collection set of poets during the turn of the century. But what I found really interesting is that all the poets that she photographed were all Scottish, but she was the only one there who was African, from African descent, Ghanaian descent, which really showed how ahead of her time and how trailblazing she was, because it's very rare to hear about an African being a poet and then hearing about an African woman being a poet, you know, being one of the first ones in Scotland to pioneer and go that direction. It's very inspiring. And her accomplishments can't even fit this whole podcast, because she's done so much. She was a boss of energy and drive, you know, and she was really a trailblazer. Somebody who wanted to do things first, as shown by the magazine she published, the Urban Fox Press. And during her relatively short life, she made sure to let everybody know that being an African is important and by accepting that African side, you have a strong Afro-Scot identity.